Hello, I'm Artifacts of Mars, and this is the Tyranny Watch News Field Report. I'm at Conesus Lake, and I think technically it's in Geneseo where I'm at, but at any rate, this is called the Fiddler's Picnic. You might be able to hear a little fiddle music in the background. What they have is they have main bands here, and then you'll have these splinter groups that love to come together and play their fiddle music. That's what you're hearing. Let's see if I can focus in on. Mostly older folk here. Younger folks are listening to god-awful stuff that I can't, some of it I can't even identify. I was at a Dollar General earlier, and somebody was blasting something I had no idea even what it was. But I fell in love with this music a long time ago. I don't know if these are professional musicians or whether they're amateurs, but they sure sound good. I'm going to document a little bit more of this. This isn't the main area, obviously. I'll be moving around to some extent. You can see the lake in the background. And Conesus Lake, as you can see, is ringed with houses and whatnot. This place is Long Pond, Long Point Park or something like that. I know where it is. I drive to it every day, every year, just for this. Lots of times, like I said, these splinter bands are better than the paid ones that are over in the big tent. I will go over to the big tent. Come roll. Okay, it's main tent. They couldn't really seem to settle on a name for the band, so I'm not sure what they're called. First time I ever heard Johnny Cash's Folsom Prison Blues set to a fiddle. It was interesting, to say the least. to understand where this music came from, you have to understand where the ancestors of people came from, especially white folk. I would hazard a guess a lot of it had to do with the Irish potato famine. If you know your history, the Irish were starving, and they came over here trying to find something to eat, basically. Of course, they brought their music with them. In the early days of the old folk towns and such, you didn't have any cell phones, you didn't have any stereos, you didn't have any electricity. And what they would do is they would supply their own entertainment. Now, at first it was the fiddles would have catgut strings, and that wasn't very loud, not to mention it wasn't very nice to the cats either. Eventually the steel strings were invented, and people would get together and supply their own entertainment because you didn't have any other way. Now, the Celts, Irish, the Scotch, you know, they came over here with their fiddles and other acoustic instruments, and they really helped shape the character of this country. I was at a Dollar General earlier in the day and getting some supplies, and somebody had something completely indescribable on their stereo. I had no idea even what it was. My, how things have changed. But these traditional musics are kind of hanging around, and hopefully they'll hang around for a long time. They'll outlive me, that's for sure. Now, what are my ethnic roots? Don't know. Don't care. I had this running joke that I'm a descendant of Attila the Hun, but I don't know for sure. Well, we're waiting for the next band. Place is packed. Everybody's happy. This may be a Tyranny Watch News field report, but there's no tyranny here. Kind of breezy day. Very warm. Very nice day. Ah, this is the life. I actually took off from work to come here. We'll wait for the next band and get one or two of their songs. I'm not going to do the whole thing here. Phantom Indian of Conesus Lake, promoted by Colonel S. Tui, appeared by moonlight and canoes calling for help, tale still shared today. That's what the sign says here. That's a new one on me. I'm going to have to look this one up. Like, you know, most other places, this area is very highly steeped in Indian lore and Indian names and so forth. I'm assuming Canisius is an Indian name. I don't know. I worked for years with an American Indian girl, and I didn't know she was an American Indian until she told me one day. New York Folklore Society, William C. Pomeroy Foundation, 2016. I have to look that one up. That explains why I've never seen this before. 2016 is last year, the last time I came here. What you're listening to is a tune called San Antonio Rose. This is Western Swing. Deep within my heart, Sorry about shaking. Setting up the tripod. Probably gonna have to hold this thing because this tripod was bought in a thrift shop and it's not that good in some respects. Songs by a group that introduced me to the brand of music called Western Swing, which was Asleep at the Wheel. I'd never heard of such a thing before. It was an immediate hit with me.
bluegrass. Cause I sit and pick the chick stacks. There ain't nobody here but us. There ain't nobody here at all. So watch yourself, stop letting go. There ain't nobody here but us.
Thank you.
Bob Wills tune named Faded Love.
Thank you.
I met a one, you know his name was Silver Joe. I grabbed the hole in his rifle, just to ride the solo I thought. From the side.